During the Taiyuan period of the Jin Dynasty, there was a man from Wuling County who made a living by fishing. One day, as he pulled his boat along a stream, he forgot how far he had gone. Suddenly, he stumbled upon a peach blossom grove on the riverbank, a few hundred steps wide, with no other trees mixed in. The grass was lush, and the fallen petals were in riotous profusion. The fisherman was quite surprised, so he kept pulling forward, trying to find the end of the grove. The end of the grove was the source of the stream, where he found a mountain. There was a small opening that seemed to have some light shining through it. He left his boat there and went in through the opening. At first, it was very narrow and only just wide enough for a single person to pass through. After walking several tens of steps, he suddenly found himself in an open area. The land was flat and the houses looked orderly. There were good fields, beautiful ponds, and plants like bamboos and mulberry trees. The paths between the farms were connected and roosters and dogs could be heard. The people there, both men and women, dressed like outsiders, walking and working in the fields. The old and the young all seemed happy and contented. When they saw the fisherman, they were greatly surprised and asked where he had come from. The fisherman answered in detail. Then some of the villagers invited him to their home, treating him with wine and chicken. Upon hearing about the fisherman, people in the village all came to inquire. They told him that, in order to escape the chaos during the Qing Dynasty, their ancestors had left their home with their wives, children, and neighbors and come to this isolated place. They had never left since and had cut themselves off from the outside world. They asked the fisherman what dynasty it was, not knowing about the Han Dynasty, not to mention the Wei and Jin Dynasties. The fisherman told them everything he had heard, and they were all sentimental and amazed. The other villagers invited him home in turn, all treating him with wine and food. After staying for several days, the fisherman left. The villagers told him, "This is not worth mentioning to outsiders." After leaving, he found his boat and went back along the same way, marking the way everywhere. When he reached the county seat, he went to see the governor and told him about what he had discovered. The governor immediately sent people to follow the fisherman and find the marks he had made, but they got lost and could not find the way again. Liu Zuji from Nanyang was a noble scholar. When he heard about this, he eagerly planned to go and find the place. He failed and soon became ill and died. Afterwards, no one ever asked about it again.